The Anatomy, Embracing Urban Ephemerals, Market-Based Socioeconomic Neighborhood Development Initiative. Depending on my final year research on urban ephemerals and built environment, this design thesis comes as an attempt to extend the same research issue into an architectural intervention within local context. Architecture, urban design and city planning historically endeavored towards permanence, but nowadays we all know cities are no more steady but ephemeral. Currently, people in contemporary South Asian cities are struggling to facilitate their varying needs due to less responsiveness of the urban built environment they are provided with. Therefore, what does the next step of city development needs to be to make the future cities better responsive? That was where I started. Consequently, my design position is, in order to achieve the notion of responsive urban spaces, built anatomy of urban space needs to be designed in a way which embraces the ephemerality of user requirements. After several pilot studies, the low-income community along Ferguson's Road, starting from Thottalanga Junction at Kalani River Edge within Colombo City, became the best match to demonstrate my design position. This context is more significant due to Thottalanga public market operated from historical eras, and currently it's operating by the focused community as a self-organized public layer. Given permanent market building is currently not functioning at all and the community is currently operating the market as a flea market along the street within the river reservation with many difficulties. At the same time, Thottalanga community is threatened by the government proposals to relocate them into a housing block away from their breeding space. Therefore, the overall design intervention is rather eliminating. It is more efficient to upgrade urban low-income communities with higher socioeconomic cultural values in order to consequence better responsive urban spaces while using my design position as a tool. Current market building location is chosen as the site considering the potentials to be designed as a main node of the proposed socioeconomic development. And I should say, this is the exact location of the famous Thottalanga Vesak Thorana as well. And also, my site has a panoramic view of river and a canal. The overall development comes as a master plan proposal with four phases, supported with the community members. First, the clearing river edge and restoring ecological layer. And secondly, it will be upgrading road-facing shop houses and inner community spaces. And in the third place, market arena installation take place. And finally, the riverine corridor installation happens with the least disturbance to the river edge ecological corridor restored. This riverine corridor acts as the linking component of the riverine development proposed by the government as well, in between old and new Kalani River bridges. Here in the layout plan, you can see the overall building layout is a combination of two building wings to facilitate dry and wet market. Also, there's a series of retail shops proposed along the canal linking the market arena into the lower level road. Service nodes plug into the layout in between market wings, adding solid permanent building masses into the overall layout. Irregular, organic shape of the layout arrangement efficiently provide better indoor as well as outdoor rooms, enhancing physical and visual interaction all over the building. The bigger open space wrapped by the proposed built anatomy contains as the only bigger space of the overall community, which they have to operate all the multiple cultural, economical, religious and festive activities. It is paved and the tiers are improved as seating spaces. Nearby the boat tree and the stupa, you can see the riverine corridor creeps into the building at an elevated level, providing a provision skeletal to form the annual Vesak Thorana and other seasonal installations. Here in the ground floor, it's a fully public layer, and considering the accessibility from more directions at the location, ground floor is designed as an open platform. And it welcomes a wide variety of users from different directions, and people can freely flow into the market arena. And the ground floor is elevated 0.8 meters on a solid plinth, and people can get on through ramps. Community side wing contains a series of grocery poultry stalls, and the canal side wing operates with a series of vegetables and fresh fruit stalls, and the retail shops along the canal allows a variety of choices to the user. Here in the first floor, the riverine corridor creeps into the building right at the first floor level at an end. It runs through the building, linking the stalls, community bank and the cafe dining space in the first floor. And the same pathway continues over the canal as a bridge, linking the people live ahead the canal into the market arena. And also you can see there are several pedestrian bridges which links the inner communal spaces over the road into the building at the first floor level. Also you can see the solid service blocks create an intermediate layer of spaces open for communal and vending activities. Vertical circulation is encouraged within the building floors through spacious and pedestrian ramps provided. Second floor spreads only over a limited area of the layout and it's mostly a space for community members. There's a play space for kids from the community, a small scale fitness center in the middle for the community, and also there's an admin office and a riverine habitat stewardship office operated by the community. The sectional elevation across canal and retort shapes shows the space arrangement within and the elevated view of the main market arena behind. Elevation from canal side manifests the overall built arrangement and one who walks into the building through canal bridge can experience this view. Here the two sectional elevations present the elevated view of each building wing from the center in between two buildings. Detailed section across the community side market wing directly shows the arrangement of stalls and circulation over two floors. Building core is supported with the steel structure and the roof is secondarily supported with the secondary outer 3D truss columns, adding an outer skin for the built anatomy. Space is sheltered with the lower roof part done with fabric membrane and the main upper roof is done with zinc aluminium sheets. Cross-section across the entry foyer in between two market wings with a double height space shows the vertical arrangement of the space. Again here you can see the core area operates as a main market space while the outer layer of the building is designed with retractable, movable and adjustable building elements to facilitate the outer layer of socio-economic activities. When we focus into the building production, production of the building is an assembly of various building elements over a solid plinth with uncomplicated types of joineries and details. Overall building language, outlook and the expression resulted largely rely on the vivid usage of materials. Extensive use of local locust materials, material hybridization, inspiring from the surrounding context and thermal comfort is regarded. Using the first floor plan, here I have shown how a single floor is composed with different materials in different areas. And you can see the red colored strip shows the riverine corridor continuing through the first floor level, which is done with a rustic use of scaffolding pallets. Physical models reveal the lighting effects resulted with the building interior spaces due to materiality. Here the key map with different colors concludes the spread of service nodes and the different types of vending spaces designed as a built anatomy all over the building. Therefore, the built anatomy is designed with a higher percentage of spaces which are responsive to the user, allowing personalization while embracing ephemerality. And the lower diagram illustrates the transformation of market arena as a whole in different seasons, including a normal market operating day and a Vesak Thorana season day. Design specific details and the responsive utility of the built anatomy is explored here with a series of diagrams and sketches. And finally, the spread of fixed solid service nodes are summarized here with their utility all over the layout. And let me bring you in and around the building. Here is the perspective view of the wet market wing from the bigger open space, and this is the community side grocery. And this is the view of the building one can experience when walk along the low level road into the building, and there people can freely walk into the market arena. And here you can see the ramps creeping into the building along the canal and the bridge over the canal which welcomes people from ahead the canal. And also there I have shown a sectional perspective showing the vertical arrangement of services and the arrangement of all three floors. This is an elevated view of the grocery stores and the other communal spaces within the building, where one can experience from the in between the two marketings. Finally, this is the overall outlook of the overall built arrangement when it lies over the selected context. Thank you.